Okay, in this video we're going to conclude our discussion of coordinate transformations, and hopefully this is going to bring together what we've talked about in the previous videos. So you may remember that we've gone to a lot of trouble to establish relationships between the position coordinates in different coordinate systems. Particularly we focused on Cartesian coordinates, where position is located in terms of the components x, y, and z, and the cylindrical coordinates, where they're expressed in terms of the components r, theta, and z. And we also looked at the velocity vectors and how those components are expressed or can be related, and how derivatives associated with those velocity components can be expressed. And the reason for that is that you may remember when we talked about conservation of mass that we end up with a differential equation that involves position and velocity and derivatives of these quantities. So in order to transform between coordinate systems, we need to be able to express these relationships between them. And so this is complicated. If we want to take this expression of the conservation of mass in Cartesian coordinates, where we have the partial derivative with respect to x of the x component of velocity, plus the partial derivative with respect to y of the y component of velocity, plus the partial derivative with respect to z of the z component of velocity equals zero. Right, this is the form that the equation takes, assuming an incompressible flow. If we want to express this, the corresponding equation in cylindrical coordinates, it's not so straightforward. We can't just say it's the partial of vr with respect to r plus the partial of v theta with respect to theta plus the partial of vz with respect to z. And the reason is, if you remember when we talked about the velocity vectors in the Cartesian system, the x and y axes remain fixed in space, whereas in the cylindrical system, the r and theta unit vectors can change their orientation depending on the orientation of the velocity vector. And so since the orientation between the two, relative orientation between the two coordinate systems, can be constantly changing, then that introduces some additional things that we need to consider in this coordinate transformation. So choosing these coordinates and establishing relationships between them is actually not a trivial thing. And as if you get into more complex flows, deformations of non-Newtonian fluids, those issues become even more important. But we're not worried about that for the purposes of this class. So with the background that we've established in the previous videos, now we can start to look at these components. So let's start with the first component, the partial derivative of u with respect to x. So this is the partial derivative with respect to x of u. So we obtained an expression for the velocity component u in terms of vr and v theta. So it's vr cosine theta minus v theta sine theta. So we want to take the partial derivative of x with respect to x of this quantity. And so we can do that. We know when you take a derivative of a function involving products, we can apply the chain rule. So we'll do that. And then I'm also going to say that I can express this derivative with respect to x as the partial derivative of r with respect to x times the partial derivative with respect to r of vr cosine theta minus v theta sine theta plus the partial derivative of theta with respect to x times the partial with respect to theta of vr cosine theta minus v theta sine theta. So remember, because x can depend on r and theta, then this gives me a complete mapping of the derivatives in terms of the interdependence of these variables. Okay, and so now I can go through and evaluate the derivative with respect to r and theta of these terms. And so that's what I'm going to do here in the next step. And also we have the same thing for the partial derivative with respect to z. But this is a wash, because these components vr and v theta don't have a component in the z direction, because it's an orthogonal, the z direction is orthogonal to the r and theta directions. Okay, so then we just work through this. The partial derivative of r with respect to x is cosine theta. We found that previously. And then we can work through here. So the partial derivative of vr with respect to r times cosine theta plus the partial derivative of cosine theta with respect to r times vr. But cosine theta doesn't have a derivative with respect to R, so we don't get a term from this derivative, so I've left that out here. And then the same thing, the partial derivative with respect to R, we can apply the chain rule here. So the partial derivative of V theta with respect to R times sine theta plus the partial derivative of sine theta with respect to R times V theta. And again, sine theta, because R and theta are orthogonal, there's no derivative with respect to R is zero. So we're just left with these two terms when we evaluate their partial derivative with respect to R. Similarly, we can do the same thing for the theta direction. So previously we found that the partial derivative of theta with respect to x is minus sine theta over r. And then we can evaluate the partial derivative with respect to theta of these components. And so here both vr and v theta can have theta dependence. So in general, so we get all the terms when we use the chain rule. So we have partial derivative of vr with respect to theta times cosine theta. Minus the partial derivative of cosine theta with respect to theta. So the derivative of cosine is negative sine. So we have minus VR sine theta. So those two come from this term. And then the partial derivative of theta of V theta with respect to theta times sine theta. So we have that term. And then we have V theta times the partial derivative of sine theta with respect to theta. So the derivative of sine is cosine. So we have minus V theta cosine theta. And then, like I said before, we get nothing for the partial derivative with respect to Z, because there's no Z dependence of these quantities. Okay, so now we can collect terms and see what we end up with. So we have partial derivative of U with respect to X is the partial derivative of VR with respect to R times cosine squared theta, minus partial derivative of V theta with respect to R times sine theta cosine theta, minus 1 over R partial of VR with respect to theta sine theta cosine theta, plus 1 over R partial of V theta with respect to theta times sine squared theta, plus 1 over R VR sine squared theta, plus 1 over R V theta sine theta cosine theta. So we end up with all these terms. And then similarly, we can go through exactly the same analysis for the other components. So we can evaluate dv dy, and we get similar terms. Partial of vr with respect to r sine squared theta plus partial of v theta with respect to r sine theta cosine theta plus 1 over r partial of vr with respect to theta sine theta cosine theta plus 1 over r partial of v theta with respect to theta times cosine squared theta plus 1 over r vr cosine squared theta minus 1 over r v theta sine theta cosine theta. And then we just get for the z component that the partial with respect to z of the z component of velocity is the same in both of the coordinate systems, Cartesian and cylindrical. Okay, so now we can notice a few things to combine these, because remember the conservation of mass is the sum of these, or the continuity equation is the sum of these partial derivatives. So notice that these terms cancel. We have a plus partial of v theta with respect to r sine theta cosine theta and a minus partial of v theta with respect to r sine theta cosine theta. So those cancel. And then there's some other terms that cancel also. This one cancels because of a plus here and a minus here. And this term cancels. So all the terms that involve products of sine theta and cosine theta cancel. Also, some other terms add together. So here I have two terms, partial of VR with respect to R, and I have a cosine squared theta here and a sine squared theta here. And I see the same thing also with this term, 1 over R partial of V theta with respect to theta. So I get that has a common term of sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta. And the same for this other term, 1 over r vr. And so remember that the trig identity, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. Right? So when I add these together, the sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta part just equals 1. So these simplifications allow me to reduce the continuity equation as follows for cylindrical coordinates. So I get that the partial derivative of VR with respect to R plus 1 over R partial derivative of V theta with respect to theta plus 1 over r vr plus partial of vz with respect to z equals 0. So this is an expression of the continuity equation, or the differential form of the conservation mass of mass in cylindrical coordinates. And so you can see that it's not a one-to-one mapping, especially you don't just substitute u, v, and w with vr, v theta, and vz. You have a little bit different. You have a 1 over r term here multiplying partial of v theta with respect to theta, and then you have another term here that's completely different as a result of this coordinate transformation. We also talked about a more compact way to express this equation in terms of the gradient or the del operator. So we can see that in cylindrical coordinates, or the del of something, is the partial derivative of something with respect to r times the unit vector in the r direction plus 1 over r partial derivative of something with respect to theta in the theta direction plus the partial derivative of something with respect to z in the z direction. So now, using the geometry that we examined in the previous videos, we found that we can, if we're careful and we keep track of what we're doing, we can transform these velocity vector components and their derivatives from Cartesian coordinates into other coordinate systems, and specifically we showed here how that works for the case of cylindrical coordinates. So the idea is just basically geometry and comparing triangles. You end up with some complicated looking equations, but I just want you to remember that the basic idea is just geometry. The details make it look complicated, but the basic ideas are straightforward, and given enough time, I think you could sit down and figure it out.